Water managers in the West have a tough job. And one of the critical inputs for water managers is knowing how much runoff will come into the reservoirs when that snowpack melts. They need to know what's coming in addition to what they already have. And so they'll meet some fixed targets, you know, perhaps for environmental flows that they know they always have to meet. But then they may have extra that they can send to other uses. And I think the forecasts are a critical part of improving those decisions. If we knew perfectly what was coming in, we could really probably make the optimal use of that water, but we never do. Being able to forecast that a little bit better should help us kind of adapt to those changes. But the main questions that we're trying to answer within this project have to do with the kinds of predictions that are used by water managers to make decisions over water throughout various places in the country, and whether or not we're harnessing all the advances that have been made in other supporting disciplines like weather forecasting or climate forecasting or hydrological modeling to make better predictions that can be used operationally in water management. You know, and so in some seasons you may be able to do a really good job of predicting stream flow into a reservoir. In other seasons, there may be so much variability in the precipitation and the kinds of weather systems that you get that you have a very hard time predicting stream flow. And so we're trying to tease out what some of those differences are around the country. The main influences on the stream flow prediction are how much moisture we have being stored up in the watershed, say in the form of snow, or if we've had a wet fall, you may have very wet soils under a snowpack. And then also how much the climate systems to come in the spring will bring to add to that, or maybe whether they'll be dry and take away from what you would normally expect. And being able to separate out those two sources of predictability and look at how we characterize them and whether we're doing the best we can is a really critical part of the research right now. If you look at phenomena like drought up in the upper Midwest, I mean, millions of dollars, perhaps billions of dollars worth of crop-related losses occurred because people planted in the spring not knowing that they were facing this one of the most widespread droughts in history. And that, to me, is partly a forecasting challenge, you know, that we were unable to forecast the climate conditions that led to that drought even a few months out. And yet there's a lot of work in that area and a lot of things that haven't been tried yet operationally that I think as researchers we can try to dig our teeth into and extract value from. So it's very motivating.